If you tried the two circular needles technique successfully, the one circular needle technique won't be a challenge either. So for this video, I use my beloved signature needles, my newly bought. I love them. Stiletto tip, and it's metal needles with a very soft, flexible cable. For my opinion, it's a little too thin. So creators of signature needles, I would love to have thicker cables, if that's possible, but still soft, of course. So for knitting a sock with one circular needle, you again leave a tail of about 40 to 50 centimeters and you cast on all the stitches, in this case 24 stitches, and you take care of leaving a little space between the stitches when casting on. This makes for a more elastic edge. So don't knit the stitches too tightly. Knit them with a little spacing in between the stitches. And again, in this video, I only show the technique of knitting a sock with one circular needle. There will be separate videos for casting on and for binding off. What I do first, after having cast it on, I'm getting the starting thread out of the way. So I'm wrapping a tiny ravel with a simple knot around. And bingo, it's out of the way. One simple knot around, tied tightly. Now, what we are going to do is we're dividing the number of stitches into half, so 12 stitches. And after 12 stitches, we want the cable of the needles sticking out. So we pull it out in the center of the stitches. And now you clearly see the right side of your cast on. The wrong side has little bumps. We turn the work so the wrong sides facing each other inside for the following tube we are going to knit. Now we start to work the front needle stitches. So we slide them to the top of the needle. The other needle is pulled out of the stitches. We need it for knitting. So little knots inside. Now we start knitting half of the first round. And I'm showing you knit stitches only, just for demonstration purpose. Be careful not to knit the first stitch too tightly. It would make problems when sliding the stitches between cable and needle. So first half of the first round. Now we need the other stitches on the tip of the needle. So we slide them to the tip of the needle. You see the last stitches here are very tight already. And now we knit with the other end of the needle. we pull it out of the stitches we just worked. And now we continue knitting 12 stitches. I'm just showing you the technique with one circular needle now. So we don't care about how we cast on. I used a standard cast on, standard continental cast on. And we are just concentrating on the technique. There will be more videos about casting on and binding off. So then you turn the work and the first stitch of the second round is again worked with two threads, with the starting thread and the working thread. You slide the stitches again to the tip of the needle, and the first stitch of the second round is worked with both strands of yarn. Remember when starting the next round that this first stitch is one stitch only, despite the two threads of yarn. And continue just knitting. First half of second round. So remember this first stitch when you start the next round, that this is only one stitch. Turn the work, pull out the needle. Be careful, it's better to first slide the stitches to the tip of the needle and then pull out the other end of the needle entirely. And continue knitting. So, this was the magic of the magic loop. Not too difficult, and maybe for beginners who feel the five needle play, it's an easier way to start with sock knitting. So, and here you already can see the tube that will form your sock. Enjoy.